Good morning, children. We know that basically when light falls on the surface, either it gets reflect or refract or it has been absorbed. So as we know already, the reflection is a bouncing back of a light, whereas refraction is the one, it allow the light to enter into the object. Allow the light it enter into the object, but some changes will happen. Let us move on to that. Refraction of light. Will you be able to see the picture? A straw has been kept inside the glass full of water. But you can see the star doesn't look straight. You can see it appear to be bent. This is what we call it as a refraction of light. Yes, how come the refraction happened? You know, children, we can basically take the transparent medium. You know the air is a transparent medium. Yes, there are air molecule around us through which we are able to see the object. For example, if you keep a book in front of you, in between the book and yourself, there is an air. That is a transparent medium. And similarly, you keep water inside the transparent glass, you may able to view and certain things behind the glass. Clear? So what I like to tell you is, transparent medium, we can call it as an optical medium. We can call it as an optical medium. When the light enters from one optical medium to another optical medium. For example, look at the picture. Above the water, air is in one of the optical medium. When it light enter into the water, it is an another optical medium. So when the light enters from one optical medium to another optical medium, the change of direction of light happens. So when the straw appeared to be straight up to the surface of the water, when it enter into the water, it appeared to be bent. So this one we call it as a refraction. Let me repeat again. When the light travels from one optical medium to another optical medium, the direction of the light gets changed. The direction of the light gets changed. Instead of traveling straight, it will appear to bend. So this one we call it as a refraction of light. Now you have to think, see, there are certain cases this optical medium will keep on change. For example, air to water, sometime water to air, something like that it will change. In that case, how does the change in direction happen? Let me explain you. If you see this glass, the surface above the water we call it as an air. Below that we call it as a water. You know, the density of the air is very lesser when compared to the density of the water. So if you see the all three state of matter, you can tell that solid is more denser when compared to a liquid, followed by a gas. So that means whichever it is denser, we call it as an, when whichever the density is more, we call that part as a denser. Whichever it is little free for the air molecules or the particles to move, we call it as an rarer. So less dense area called as a rarer, and the more dense area we call it as a denser. So when the light enter from a rarer to a denser medium, it bend towards the normal. The best example is the picture one. You can see the air from the light from the air, it travels into the water as a denser medium. So it bend towards a normal. If you draw a perpendicular line, when the light enter into the water, it move towards the perpendicular line. If the opposite is happening, if the light is traveling from a denser to a rarer medium, the light is traveling from denser to a rarer medium. In that case, you may able to see the change in direction is away from the normal. Away from the normal. Whereas if the light falls perpendicular to the surface, There is no deviation. It just travels straight into the object without any refraction. So basically, refraction is an change of direction of light when it travels from one medium to another medium. If it falls at certain angle of incidence, if it falls exactly at 90 degree without any refraction, it just passes through the object. Whereas if it makes in some angle, if it is rarer to denser, it moves towards the normal. If it is a denser to rarer, it moves away from the normal. Children, in reflection, we will use a shiny surface. So basically, we can call it as a mirror. There are different types of a mirror: plane mirror, concave mirror, convex mirror. Whereas in refraction, that happens in a lens. So there are two main types of a lens. One is a convex lens, another one is a concave lens. So the lens are either made up of a glass or a plastic. So concave lens is the one thin at the center, whereas bulged at the edges. Whereas a convex lens is bulged at the center, whereas thin at the edges. You can see the picture. The first one is a convex, second one is a concave. Convex lens are otherwise known as a converging lens. Converging means after a refraction or a reflection, basically, okay, all the rays will meet each other. Diverging means it moves away from each other. So, converging lens in the sense, when the light falls on the convex lens after refraction, you know, when the light falls, you travel from rarer to a denser medium, it undergo refraction. Instead of traveling straight, you can see the light ray bend. So after refraction, the refracted rays meet at a point. So that one we call it as a converging lens. We'll move on to a diverging lens. You know, the opposite of converging is a diverging. So when the incident ray enters into a concave lens, after refraction, after changing the direction, they all move away from each other. So based on this property, it forms a different type of an image. Have you seen, remember the video that I showed you in the last class that shows a different type of an image formed by a convex lens? Small image, thoda big, same size, and it is really very big when compared to an object. So all these are image formed by the convex lens. So the convex lens forms a real as well as a virtual image, whereas a concave lens forms only a virtual image. I hope you remember the differences between the real and a virtual image.